Dear friends, a broken haptic in the IOL implantation is not unusual, and this was one such case. The trailing haptic got trapped in the cartridge and was truncated. When I implanted, I saw that the length has subluxated downwards. So now I take up the case to explant this length and insert a new lens. The case was done in the morning. At the conclusion, I realized that one haptic has been broken off. The lens was a bit decentered, so I closed the case, waited for a few hours, and in the afternoon when I saw the case, this was the picture. So I decided I have to remove this lens and put in another one. The first thing that I was doing is to put some visco below the lens and try to take it out of the bag, especially the intact haptic. I'm using two instruments, the visco cannula and a Koblenz hook, and trying to coax the lens out of the bag. And I've managed to get the haptic out. This is a single piece hydrophobic preloaded lens from Appa. I'm using a Ultratug. I should be using a MacPherson, but the tips of the MacPherson were not good, so I used the Ultratug for this. Pulled out the intact haptic to the wound. My aim would be to deepen the AC as much as possible and keep this lens as anterior as possible. I engage the haptic in the wound so that it doesn't slip back. Put in some more visco under it and lift the IOL totally out in front of the pupillary plane in the AC. Deepening the AC further. I'm using a Varnas to cut the lens. A Koblenz hook to stabilize it from the other end. The biggest problem here is, if you like to take a bold cut, you'll have to open the blades more, and the posterior blade is quite likely to damage the posterior capsule. I cut the lens just halfway till the center of it. Now I shall bring the intact haptic near the wound so that I can grasp it and pull out the lens. After a neatly done surgery, having a rent at this stage would be very tragic. Time and again, I deepen the AC, push back the posterior capsule away from my instrumentation. With the faucet, I pull out this haptic and engage the cut part of the lens, rotate it. Use the wound as a pivot, rotate it, and bring it out. And the broken lens is out. of this step is routine implantation of another lens. Apart from the dent in the pocket of the surgeon, the biggest concern was not to create a dent in the posterior capsule, in which I succeeded. Implanting another similar lens, both the haptics are fine, the leading haptic has gone in the bag. These air bubbles are a beautiful bonus, and I tuck in the trailing haptic in the bag. I heave a sigh of relief that I did not face any complication in explanting and re-implanting another lens. You do face such a situation once in a while, and once be prepared how to